हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल रीड अनदर पोएम दैट इज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड फॉर यू. द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम इज डेसिडराटा एंड इट इज रिटन बाय एन अमेरिकन पोएट मैक्स एयरमन. The special thing about this poem is that it is a prose poem. It is written in a single block. There are no stanzas and there is also no rhyming scheme as such. For our convenience, while we read the poem, we will divide it in some parts, some sections. Okay. It's a poem written in 46 lines. The word desiderata means the things that are wanted. And it's a poem written for a daughter. The poet wrote this poem for his daughter. So here are some wise words, some suggestions, some guidance from a father to a daughter. So first we'll read some sections of the poem, and also we'll see the meanings of the different words. I read, "Go placidly amid the noise and waste." Placidly, in a calm, peaceful manner. Amid, in the middle of or surrounded by. Amid is a preposition. Placidly is an adverb. Go placidly amid the noise and haste. Noise. Lots of sounds. Loud, unpleasant sounds. And haste is hurry. So, there is a suggestion in the very first line of the poem. Go placidly amid the noise and haste. And remember what peace there may be in silence. Peace, freedom from disturbance, freedom from noise. There may be in silence. Silence is the complete absence of sound. Peace and silence, both are the nouns. Remember is a verb. And remember what peace there may be in silence. I always advise my students that you should look at the poem or any piece of writing, particularly meant for a compulsory class, as a means to study language. So first of all, we should concentrate upon the words, what different types of words are there used and how they are used. Go placidly amid the noise and haste and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible without surrender. Surrender. Here it is, a noun, the act of stopping, fighting and officially admitting defeat. That is surrender. As far as possible without surrender. Be on good terms, having good relation with somebody. Be on good terms with all persons. So the poet has a suggestion that we should maintain good relationship with all persons, with all people. We should be friendly with all. So it's a It's a didactic poem. Didactic, it teaches us many things. This poem has so many instructions for us, for our code of conduct, for our moral behavior. So that is the purpose of didactic poetry. It teaches us many things. Speak your truth quietly and clearly. But we should not remain behind in speaking the truth. The poet has another advice. We should speak our truth quietly and clearly. Quietly, in a quiet manner. Quietly, adverb. Clearly. Again an adverb. Plainly, distinctly, with clarity. Clearly. And listen to others. On the other, we should speak our truth clearly, boldly, honestly, he says. But on the other hand, we should listen to others also. Even the dull and the ignorant. Dull, lacking interest, excitement, boring. And the ignorant, lacking knowledge. So, we should even listen to the people who are not interesting or who don't have much knowledge. They are ignorant or they are dull. Because the next line says, they too have their story. Because the poet says that these people also have their stories, and it is our duty to not only to speak our truth clearly, but to listen to others also. So, this is the first section of the poem. We will continue in the next video. Thank you.